KU.edu.
You're watching KCPT, Kansas City.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the Lawrence Welk Show, celebrating more than 60 years on television. Now sit back and enjoy the show selected especially for public television.
Hello, I'm Mary Lou Metzger, and welcome to the Lawrence Welk Show. The theme of the upcoming program is All About the South. It was taped in 1967 and features guest star Anita Bryant. On this show, we'll see our beautiful champagne lady, Norma Zimmer, singing Sleepy Time Down South, the Lennon sisters singing Stars Fell on Alabama, and our wonderful Welk Orchestra playing Carolina in the Morning. At the end of this program, I have a very special visit with Welk star Kathy Lennon, who provides us with some fascinating stories about the Lennon sisters performing more than 50 years in show business. So stay with us. And now, here's the maestro himself, Lawrence Welk.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Greetings, friends, and a warm welcome to you all. This evening, we'll take you on a musical journey through the South. It's just about train time, so all aboard.
Hello there, stranger, and how do you do?
There's something I'd like to say to you.
Now, don't be surprised, but you're recognized.
I'm no detective, but I've just surmised.
You're from the place where I want to be.
Your smiling face seems to say to me,
you're from my own land,
my sunny homeland.
Tell me, can it be?
Are you from Dixie?
Yeah, we're from Dixie, where the fields of cotton beckon to me.
We're glad to see you.
Tell me, how be you? And the friends I'm longing to see.
If you're from Alabama, Tennessee, or Carolina,
have a little souvenir for each and every one
to make your trip to Dixie just a little bit more fun.
And when you hear the music that is played in Dixieland,
you can pick this souvenir up and join in with the band.
Southern trip. We have an extra passenger this evening, the lovely and talented Anita Bryant from Tulsa, Oklahoma, and we'll meet her a little later in the show. Right now, we find our lovely champagne lady, Norma Zimmer, in a pretty outdoor setting as she sings a familiar ballad, Sleepy Time Down South.
Pale moon shining on the fields below. Folks are crooning songs soft and low. Needn't tell me so, because I know it's sleepy time down south. Soft winds blowing through the pine wood trees. Folks down there live a life of ease. When old Mammy falls upon her knees, it's sleepy time down south. Steamboats on the river are coming, are going, splashing the night away. Hear those banjos ringing, the folks are a-singing, they dance till break of day. Dear old Southland with its dreamy songs takes me back there where sleepy time down south.
Just beautiful, Norma. What a wonderful way this charming lady has with a song. Next, we feature Bob Ralston at the organ. Bob Solo is the well-known song that was made so very famous by the great Al Jolson, Rockabye Your Baby with a Dixie Melody. Very appropriate, by the way, for a man with a six-week-old daughter. Bob? special guest, Anita Bryant. Anita, we're so delighted to have you with us once again.
Thank you.
What a pleasure. Isn't she nice? Isn't she nice? And can she sing? I want to tell you, I saw the Bob Hope show when you were over.
with him the other day.
Vietnam,
right. And I want to tell you something. It was such a good show, and your part was so good you did in the show. You sang that song you sang on our show here a little while back.
Battle Hymn of the Republic.
Right.
Well, you know, incidentally, I have you to thank for the success of the album, Mine Eyes Have Seen the Glory, because I introduced it on your show, and it's a big hit, and I thank you.
Oh, yes, and your album is selling very big, too, isn't it? How about you making another day to come back with us and singing that great song, How Great Thou Art?
Oh, I'd love to.
You know, I read the mail in the office, and the folks just fell in love with that song.
It's one of my favorite songs, too.
What are you going to sing for us this evening?
I have a beautiful song from Broadway, the title tune of Mame.
You may sing it.
Thank you.
Nice having you here with us.
You coax the blues right out of the horn, Mame. You charm the husk right off of the corn, Mame. You've got the banjo strumming and plunking out a tune to beat the band. The whole plantation's humming since you brought Dixie back to Dixieland. You make the cotton easy to pick, Mame. You give my homemade julep a kick, Mame. Whoever thought a Yankee would put our little Dixie bells to shame? You made us feel alive again. You've given us the drive again to make the South revive again, Mame. Oh, well, shut my mouth and freeze my face. You brought some elegance to the place. There's southerly harmony, caption dry. Oh, shut my mouth and damp my eyes. You make the price of tobacco rise. The old watermelon is suddenly ripe.
Mame.
And down on the levee, the beautiful bevy of crinoline ladies is flocked. Wee, the way that the squealing, it gives me the feeling the Robert E. Lee must have docked. The humming and strumming, the bringing and singing, it's starting to get out of hand since you brought Dixie back to Dixieland. And you make our black-eyed peas and our grits a mame seem like the bill of fare of a
Anita, please don't go away. Our boys and girls would like to have you join them later in the show. Now, here's a song you folks all remember, Carolina in the Morning, and we feature all our champagne music makers. A one and two and... Thank you.
Get on the board, the Chattanooga Choo Choo. That is, if passenger Charlie Parlota and the station crew are ready.
Say, is this the Chattanooga Choo Choo?
You better ask that guy over there.
Is this the Chattanooga Choo Choo?
Well, you'd better ask him.
Tell me, is this the Chattanooga Choo Choo?
You better ask him over there.
Wow, big spender from the East.
Say, mister, what was that question again?
Pardon me, boy. Is that the Chattanooga choo-choo?
Yes, sir.
Track 29.
Boy, you can give me the time. I can afford to board a Chattanooga choo-choo. I've got my fare and just a trifle to spare.
Yes, sir. You leave the Pennsylvania station about a quarter to four. Read a magazine and then you're in Baltimore. Dinner in the diner, nothing could be finer than to have your ham and eggs and Carolina. When you hear the whistle blow and ain't to the bar, then you know the Tennessee is not very far. Shovel all the coal in, gotta keep it rolling. Woo-woo, Chattanooga, there you are.
Now there's gonna be a certain party at the station. Satin and lace I used to call Funny Face. Now she's gonna cry until I tell her that I'll never roam. So Chattanooga choo-choo, won't you choo-choo me home? She's gonna cry until I tell her that I'll never roam. So Chattanooga choo-choo, won't you choo-choo me home? So Chattanooga choo-choo, won't you choo-choo me home?
Choo-choo, choo-choo me home. Choo-choo, choo-choo me home. Choo-choo, choo-choo me home.
Well, it looks like Charlie's traveling first class. Next stop, Georgia. Here's a pretty arrangement of a fine Hoagie Carmichael song, our recording version of Georgia on My Mind. It features our string section and Frank Scott at the piano. And Bobby are waiting to board our Dixie special. Their destination, Dallas. Let's join them.
Howdy, man.
Hi, y'all.
You're from Big D. I can guess by the way you drawl and the way you dress.
Yes, I'm from Big D.
Big D. I could guess. Big D, little A, double L-A-S.
And that spells Dallas, my darling, darling Dallas. Only give you pleasure to confess that I'm from Big D.
Big D.
My old guess.
Aha! Big D, little A, double L-A. Big D, little A, double L-A. Big D, little A, double L-A-S.
Yahoo!
Thank you.
pretty close to home for me. We used to play at the Adolphus and Baker Hotels, and two of our children were born in Dallas. Jimmy Roberts comes from Madisonville, Kentucky, so he feels right at home on this Southern tour. It's only fitting that Jimmy should sing My Old Kentucky Home. Jimmy, how you feeling?
Good. Oh, the sun shines bright on my old Kentucky home. 'Tis summer, the folks are so gay. And the corn tops ripe and the meadows in the bloom, while the birds make music all the day. The young folks roll on the little cabin floor, all merry, all happy and bright. By and by, hard times comes a knocking at the door. Then my old Kentucky home, good night. Weep no more, my lady. Oh, weep no more today. We will sing one song for the old Kentucky. For my old Kentucky home, far away.
Oh, how I love to hear My Old Kentucky Home, especially when sung by our Kentucky gentleman, Jimmy Roberts. Coming up is Arthur Duncan tapping away to deepen the heart of Texas, and Anita Bryant performing Swanee and Swanee River with our Welk musical family. And be sure to stay with us for a fascinating visit with Kathy Lennon at the end of our program. And now, back to the show.
Takes us down to Mississippi to New Orleans. Let's join the crowd and the fun as Bob Lido takes over.
What good is sitting alone in your room? Come hear the music play. Life is a cabaret, old chum. Come to the cabaret. Put down the knitting, the book and the broom. Time for a holiday. Life is a cabaret, old chum. Come to the cabaret. Come taste the wine, come hear the band, come blow the horn, start celebrating. Right this way, your table's waiting. No use permitting some prophet of doom to wipe every smile away. Life is a cabaret, old chum. Come to the cabaret. No use permitting some prophet of doom to wipe every smile away. Say life is a cabaret, old chum. Yes, only a cabaret, old chum. So come to the cabaret.
Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you ever so much. And you, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to my club, the Cabaret Lido. And I'm sure we're going to show you a good time this evening. This, we're going to have a ball, and we want you to benefit by it. And just to show you what I mean, let's give a real rousing New Orleans welcome to the Queen of the 88s, none other than Joanne Castle. Let's hear it! Ah-ha! Oh, yeah! Say one thing, this girl has more rhythm and more personality than anybody I know, and I'm sure everybody here enjoyed it, right? Ah, you kids. She's just great. She's just great. And we're going to have more. And just to show you what I mean, you people out there, join our gang over here in singing with Dick Dale, who is going to present a popular Southern hit, and the title of this is The Mighty Mississippi. Dick Dale, let's hear it!
Mighty Mississippi, roll along.
Roll along.
Daisy River, sing your song.
Sing your song.
And it's away, Dixie, steady as you go.
On your way down to the Gulf of Mexico.
Oh, old man River keeps on calling me.
Calling me.
There ain't no place on earth I'd rather be.
Rather be.
Well, it's Greenville, Vicksburg, and Natchez down the line. It's farewell, old Memphis, Tennessee. Well, I used to ride aboard that River Queen.
River Queen.
It's many a game of fortune I have seen.
I have seen.
Oh, once I lost a million and I won it back again on the way from Baton Rouge to New Orleans.
Mighty Mississippi, roll along.
Roll along.
Daisy River, sing your song.
Sing your song.
And it's away, Dixie, steady as you go.
On your way down to the Gulf of Mexico.
On your way down to the Gulf of Mexico.
On your way down to the Gulf of Mexico. Yeah!
We're just in time for a duet by a very attractive couple, Kathy Lennon and Steve Smith.
While we danced as we dreamed at the Mardi Gras, was romance what it seemed at the Mardi Gras?
Was the love that we made just a brief masquerade?
Was it gone with the song that the orchestra played? With a sigh, with a glance at the moon above?
Was it just by chance we spoke of love? Or did you somehow feel that the wonder was real while we danced at the Mardi Gras?
With a sigh, with a glance at the moon above,
was it just by chance we spoke of love? Or did you somehow feel that the wonder was real while we danced at the Mardi Gras?
That's just beautiful. That's one of my favorite songs, and so well done by both Kathy and Steve. And now you girls here and also at home, get closer to the edge of your chairs because I've got a treat for you. We've got a man from the deep, deep, deep South with the deep, 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 deep voice, Larry Hooper. What do you think about that, kid? Yeah. Hell
yeah. When sun goes down, the tide goes out, folks gather round and they all begin to shout. Hey, hey, Uncle Dud, it's a treat to beat your feet on the Mississippi mud. It's a treat to beat your feet on the Mississippi mud. What a dance do they do? Lordy, how I'm telling you, boy, they don't need no band. They keep the time by clapping their hands, just as happy as a cow chewing on a cud when the folks beat their feet on the Mississippi mud. Lordy, how they play it. Goodness, how they sway it. Uncle Joe, oh, oh, how they pound the mire with vigor and vim. Boy, that music thrills me. Joy, it nearly kills me. What a show, oh, oh, as they beat it out, either fast or slow. Sun goes down, the tide goes out, folks gather round and they all begin to shout. Hey, hey, Uncle Dud, it's a treat to beat your feet on the Mississippi mud. It's a treat to beat your feet on the Mississippi mud. What a dance do they do? Lordy, how I'm telling you, boy, they don't need no band. They keep the time by clapping their hands, just as happy as a cow chewing on a cud when the folks beat their feet on the M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-P-P-I. On the Mississippi mud.
Oh, Larry Hooper, ladies and gentlemen. What did I tell you, girls, huh? There's a treat for you. And now we have another one for you. Here, these boys right in back of me over here, they're going to pay tribute to this great city, New Orleans, and the title of the song is Way Down Yonder in New Orleans. All right, fellas, let's have it. Let's hear that beat. Oh, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a pleasure to bring back our charming guest, Anita Bryant. And Anita has promised to also sing with the group here as we go on our southern tour. And she's going to sing a very favorite Gershwin medley of Swanee. Anita Bryant.
Swanee, how I love you, how. I'd give the world to be among the folks in D-I-X. I even know my mammy's waiting for me, praying for me down Swanee. The folks up north will see me no more when I get to that Swanee shore. Swanee, how I love you, how I love you, I'd give the world to be among the folks in D-I-X. I even know my mammy's waiting for me, praying for me down by the Swanee. The folks up north will see me no more when I get to that Swanee shore.
I'm so glad you could join us for our musical tour of the South. And our special guest is that beautiful little clown you just saw dancing at the Mardi Gras. Please welcome my pal, Kathy Lennon.
Thanks, Mary. It's great to be here. Really is.
This show must bring back memories for you.
Oh, it does. You know, it was a fun show watching. The first thing that stood out for me was how gorgeous Norma always is.
Now, when you joined the show, you were little girls, and Alice Lawn was the champagne lady.
Oh, yeah.
And she was the only other female on the show. What was it like for you back then?
We were little. I was 12. Janet was like 9. And she was so glamorous and so beautiful. And she was from Texas, and she was as loud as Texas. I mean, she'd come in, "Good morning, everybody," you know. And she'd go in, and she'd get her makeup, and she'd sit there, and she would spend extra time with us. She would take us in her dressing room and let us try on her costumes, and she was very famous for her Alice Lawn petticoats, exactly. And she would put them on us, and she would get us dressed, and if we had a special date, as we got a little older, like Janet and I never got a chance to do that, but Dee Dee and Peggy, if they had something special at school or a special dance, she'd let them take one of her dresses. And when we'd go on the road with her, she would also help us get dressed, do our hair. We always wanted to do our hair like Alice, you know. And she always wore Avon hand cream. She had a kind of a skin disease that was always bothering her, so she kept cream on her. And we loved her Avon hand cream, and she'd, like, for Christmas, give us Avon hand cream, and she'd do our hands and rub our necks, and she ended up giving us petticoats, each of us, so we had her petticoats, but she was a special lady that we loved very much, very much.
Now, how about the band guys? You know, musicians are notorious.
I know they are, and can be. But being little girls, they just respected us so much and protected us. They were like our big brothers or our dads or our uncles. And they really did. There was no one, and it is notorious for studios, you know, you just got the reel and the crew and all of that. They were incredible. There was no swearing. They didn't allow anything. And they'd say, "Hey, watch it. You know, one of the kids is here. Or the Lennons are around. Stop it." They totally protected us. But I got to turn around and say, we kind of protected them, too. When we'd go on the road, and certain musicians would have a little bit too much to imbibe at night, in the morning, Mr. Welk would walk up and down the plane and say, "Good morning," to kind of check out, were they there? Are they okay? And we'd sit with them, and we'd get them aspirin if they needed, and we'd rub their necks, or we'd say, you know, "Oh, yeah, he's just sleeping," you know. So we just, like, protected them, too, in a way that, as children, we had no idea what that even meant, except that they were great guys, and we loved them. They were so good to us. And then there were certain ones that weren't married or didn't have families, and they would come to our family house for dinner on Sunday nights, like Aladdin and Bob Lido, and they'd come over and they became part of the family. And Thanksgiving they'd come over, and it just add to the...
I've heard you had some big Thanksgivings.
Oh, yeah, we always did. We always had, like, we'd have 5 tables of 10, and we'd have all the silverware and plates and everything, and we'd have at least 50 people for Thanksgiving dinner. And we'd have a buffet, and we would draw numbers for the table, what table went and got served first, you know? But it was...
Who did dishes?
All of us, for hours, and we'd sing. I mean, that's what we'd do. We'd all sit and sing because Mom didn't like plastic plates or paper plates. That was really important to have real plates for Thanksgiving especially. And we all did dishes. And that's where we sang so many harmonies. We'd come up with songs and all the little kids. And we did dishes till some 12, 1 o'clock in the morning. Nobody left till it was all done, so Mom didn't have that, you know? And then we'd also, with the band, talking about the band and how special they were to us, we would have parties periodically, once every couple months or something. We'd have big baseball parties in our backyard. And Mr. Welk would come over, and he'd love to pitch. He loved to underpitch, softball, underhand. And the musicians would play, and we'd have big parties, and the band would come over. I mean,
it was a family.
It was that family that everybody talks about or wishes for. Mm-hmm. And we were blessed to be a part of that, starting with being little children up till... You know, we got married and had children, and they still were protecting us, and we were like their sisters.
In addition to bringing the Lennon sisters to the attention of his dad, Larry Welk was also a dear, dear friend of yours.
Oh, my gosh. He was 15 when he brought us to his dad, and Dee Dee was 15 and heard us sing. They went to a party, and he thought she was singing with a choral group, and then he got there to pick her up, and it was a little bit late, and he heard us, and he said, "You know, I'm going to tell my dad about you." And... About a month later, he called and he said, my dad's home, sick with a cold, and he can't get out of the house. And he said, you know those little girls you keep bugging me about? We'll have them come over and sing. So we went over and we sang for Mr. Welk, and just walking into his elegant home, and he had on this gorgeous maroon satin smoking jacket. And he had velvet slippers on. I mean, we just thought, oh my gosh, you know, little girls from Venice, California, what did we know? And it was just incredible to be in his home. Mrs. Welk was so sweet. And we sang the song He, which was a hit for the McGuire sisters, and he said, would you consider being on my Christmas show?
You've sung for seven presidents.
We have.
You've done the Ed Sullivan show, you've everything mm-hmm. that's part of our pop culture. What was that like growing up in the spotlight?
You know, when we first started, even the first time we were on the show, and I was in seventh grade, so I was 12 years old, I was so scared of what my friends at school would say or think of me or think I would think I was big, you know, that I didn't tell anybody. And I came home and it was Christmas Eve, so we were out of school already, and it was live then. So I was scared to go back to school because Mr. Welk asked us to go on and be on after that. And I remember telling my mom, you know, I don't want to tell anybody I'm on television. You know, they'll think I'm a brat or that I'm really think I'm something. And she said, you know, anybody that you tell, if they're your real friends, they'll stay your friends and they'll be so happy for you. If they're not your real friends, that's how they'll tease you. So that's how you're going to know, and you should be proud of your job, you know, and what you do. So that always kind of stayed with me at times because it was embarrassing and it was kind of difficult because at those ages, and especially going into your teenage years, you just want to be like everybody else.
When you were the darlings of the movie magazines.
All over every, you know, every magazine cover, and even as we got older, I mean, there were things like, what the Lennons have, the Beatles want, and it's like, you know, like what? What could that possibly be? Or what Kathy could tell Liz and Jackie about love, you know? And I always wanted to read the articles, like, what could I possibly tell them? But we were in the limelight a lot, and yet considered ourselves just the little girls around the corner, because none of us were these glamorous Shirley Temple beauties. We looked like kids around the corner, you know, every one of us did. And it was hard to believe to do Ed Sullivan or Perry Como, or when Sammy Davis would come and say, hey, Kathy Jen, and I was like, you know, how do you know me or something? And one of the highlights, and I think I've shared this with you before, that we couldn't believe is that we were a Trivial Pursuit question. And it was like, oh my gosh, you know, they do kind of know our name.
Literally a part of the pop culture.
Right, just kind of it's incredible. And that's all from starting on that show. And I think it was also such a beginning of television, that's what people did. On Saturday night, they watched the Lawrence Welk show. On Sunday, they watched Ed Sullivan. On Monday, they watched Lucy. Milton Berle on Tuesday. And you didn't have this where you're watching 300 stations. It went on. And it was a family thing.
Yeah.
And you'd set so many people come up to us and say, hey, we grew up together and my grandmother made me watch
it. I still hear people talking about three generations, four generations watching it together.
Exactly. And it always brings up something to them, like a remembrance of, and my grandmother would set my hair for church the next day. Or we had hot chocolate. That was the time we had hot chocolate and marshmallows.
Uh-huh.
And it brings back a memory to people. And in Branson, it's really special because we meet people after the show and sign and take pictures. And there'll be people coming up. And there was one man who was like 91 years old. And he came up and he just had tears rolling down his face. And he said, who would have thought at 91 I could have a dream come true? You were like my granddaughters. And here I am seeing you. And it was
how
like, those are the reasons that you're on stage. And they're the ones that the loyal public, that those loyal fans that keep you there. We have been very blessed by that.
You received a star on the Walk of Fame.
Mm-hmm.
What an honor. What did that mean to you?
Well, we were shocked when they asked and to have our name, you know, in with a gold television camera, and there. And for us, I think what it meant mostly is the name the Lennon sisters, but the name Lennon to honor our dad. And I'm getting emotional about it, but our mom and dad for the specialness they had and how they loved us and were so proud of us and proud enough They allowed us to go to regular school. We never went to Hollywood Professional School. We went to regular St. Mark's Grammar School, St. Monica's High School, and allowed us to be kids, like in a world where Hollywood kids really had a lot of problems. And we would come home after singing on a show and change diapers of our little brothers and sisters, you know, and finish the dishes. And that star represented our dad's name.
Yeah.
And what they went through, and having a big family, and to say, hey, you know, we did something that the public recognized and loved us for, and they still are that loyal. And it's pretty special.
Well, thanks to the Lawrence Welk Show.
Oh.
And to public television, you get to be a part of our families forever.
Isn't that incredible?
Ever. And we're so grateful. And thank you for being here today.
Thank you for sharing. Love
and
you, Mayor.
Thank all of you for watching and continuing to watch The Lawrence Welk Show. So until next time, as Lawrence Welk always said, keep a song in your heart.
Sleep tight and pleasant dreams.